In continuation with the previous class, in previous class we started definite integrals and we had seen various problems based on definite integrals. Now we will be seeing properties of definite integrals, right? The very first property, you should remember all these property: integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to b f of z dz. Integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to b f of z dz. In this function, x is a variable, and in this function, function is in terms of variable z. But limits are from a to b, and here also limits are from a to b. If we integrate and if we substitute the limits, we will be getting the same answer. This is the meaning of this particular property. Right, now we shall see the proof also. Sometimes they may ask proofs, and it is very important to learn the proofs also. Right, let integral of f of x dx is equal to, I call this as f of t. Now, if suppose I apply the limits integral a to b f of x dx, what is the meaning here? F of t from the limits a to b. Now in this function I need to substitute upper limit as well as lower limit. So what happens? We'll be getting f of b minus f of a. So final conclusion, what can I give? Integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b, this is b, f of b minus f of a. This I will call as number one. Now, later what I'll be doing also, let integral of f of z dz I call as sum f of y. If suppose integrating this function, we'll be getting some other function, that function I name it as f of y. So similarly, I'll be applying the limits a to b f of z dz that is equal to f of y from the limits a to b. So what happens? We need to substitute the upper limit as well as we need to substitute the lower limit. So we'll be getting f of b minus f of a. So what happened? Integral a to b f of z dz we got as f of b minus f of a. So I call this as number 2. If you could observe carefully, from 1 and 2 we got the same values. Therefore, finally what I conclude, from 1 and 2, integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to b f of z dz. So it's an important property, you should remember. Integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to b f of z dz, right? In today's, now we shall go for another property. What this property is telling means, integral a to b f of x dx is equal to minus integral b to a f of x dx. That means whenever lower limit is changed to upper limit and upper limit is changed to lower limit, here comes a sign called minus, and minus of integral b to a f of x dx. We shall also see the proof of this particular property. How I will be doing means, let same pattern, integral of f of x dx is equal to, I call it as f of x. Now what I'll be doing, I'll be applying the limits integral a to b f of x dx is equal to, here what happens, f of x, and here from a to b. So what happens, we'll be getting f of b minus f of a, this is a, f of a. Therefore finally what happens, integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b, this is f of b minus f of a. So we got integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. Now later what I'll be doing, see here, this is the value we got on simplifying left hand side. Now what I'll be doing means, if suppose, if I call this, if I call as 2 and if I call as 1, Now what I'll be doing means from 1, if I multiply by minus on both sides, that means minus f of x dx means finally we'll be getting f of x, because integral of some function, integral of f of x dx is capital F of x. I multiplied by minus on both sides. Now what I'll be doing means I'll be taking the limits from b to a f of x dx, that is equal to minus I'll be keeping outside, and here f of x from the limits b to a. So finally what happens, minus of, we'll be getting upper limit substituting means f of a, lower limit substituting means minus f of b. So minus se multiply kiya to humko kya aa jata, f minus f of a plus f of b. So finally what happens, this turns down to f of b minus f of a. So finally what happened, integral of minus b to a f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. Now if I call this as some number 3, if I call this as number 3, from 2 and 3, what can I conclude? Integral a to b f of x dx is equal to minus integral b to a f of x dx. I think this is clear to you. Once again, I'm repeating, it's a second property. Integral a to b f of x dx is equal to minus integral b to a f of x dx. Let integral of f of x dx is equal to capital F of x. So on both sides I applied integral from a to b f of x dx, that is equal to f of x from a to b. Now substituting means I got as f of b minus f of a. So I call this as number 2. Later what I have done, if I call this as 1, I multiplied with minus, then applied integral. So minus of integral b to a f of x dx is equal to minus f of x from b to a. So minus common means f of a minus f of b, that is equal to minus f of a plus f of b. So integral of minus b to a f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. Please copy. Now we shall be seeing property number 3. Integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to c f of x dx plus integral of c to b f of x dx if a is less than c is less than b. It's an important property, beta. Everyone should remember this property. Integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to c f of x dx plus integral of c to b f of x dx if a is less than c is less than b. That means whenever c is lying between a and b, this kind of equality will be holding in definite integration. So I'll be proving this. So how I'll be proving means, see, let integral of f of x dx is equal to capital F of x. Now later I will apply integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of x from the limits a to b. So what happens, that implies we will be getting f of b minus f of a. So finally what I'll be concluding, integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. I call this as number 1. Now let I will call this as number 2. Now I will call this as number 1. So later what happens, now 1 implies, in 1 what I'll be doing, I'll be applying limits from a to c f of x dx, that is equal to f of x. So here what happens, a to c, so finally what I'll be getting, f of c minus f of a. I will call this as number 3. Later again also for the same equality 1, I'll be applying limits from c to b, that means c to b f of x dx is equal to f of x from c to b, that is equal to what happens, c to b I said, a to c and c to b I said. So what happens, finally we'll be getting f of b minus f of c. I call this as number 4. Therefore, finally, what I'll be doing, I'll be adding 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4 means how can we write? Integral a to c f of x dx plus integral c to b f of x dx is equal to f of c minus f of a plus f of b minus f of c. So f of c will be getting cancelled. Finally remains f of b minus f of a. So f of b minus f of a means integral a to b f of x dx. Therefore finally what I'll be concluding, integral a to c f of x dx plus integral c to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of x dx, which is the required result. This is the result, right? Now we shall be seeing another property, property 4. What this property is telling means integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. That means the sum of the limits, that means a plus b we are adding and we are subtracting. So let us see whether this is right or wrong. I'll be going by a proof. What I'll be doing means let a plus b minus x is equal to t, I'll be putting. So what happens, derivative, this is a constant, iska derivative 0, this is a constant, iska derivative 0, and here what happens, this becomes minus dx because we are doing with respect to x. That means here dt by dx comes going to that side. So minus dx is equal to dt. So what happens, dx is equal to minus dt we will be getting. So what I'll be doing, when x is equal to a, when x is equal to a, that means x ki jagah mein a substitute kare to a cancel ho jata and we'll be getting t value as b. And when I put x is equal to b, what happens, x ki jagah mein I'll be substituting b, then bb will be getting cancelled and we'll be getting t is equal to a. Therefore I will consider RHS. So integral of a to b f of a plus b minus x dx is equal to integral of a ki jagah mein I'll be substituting b and b ki jagah mein I'll be substituting a, and f of a plus b minus x means f of d, and in place of dx I need to substitute minus dt. Therefore what happens, finally that is equal to, this is b, that is equal to minus will be outside and b to a f of t dt. But there is a property 2. What is that property telling? You remember that property, integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to minus b to a f of x dx, if you remember carefully. So here also what happens, I will make lower limit as a upper limit and upper limit as lower limit, so that this minus will be getting cancelled. So what happens here, minus a to b f of t dt. So finally what happens, a to b, this turns as a f of x dx. How you got this means, we used another property. What is that property? Integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of z dz. Therefore finally what can I give a conclusion, integral a to b f of x dx is equal to integral a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. Sometimes this question they may ask in 4 marks also. You should remember this particular thing, right? Now we shall be seeing a fifth property, which is a special case of the previous property. What is the previous property? One second, I'll be devising. Integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to integral of a to b f of a plus b minus x dx. So we call this as a special case. Now how can we prove this particular thing? We shall see. Again, proof. What I'll be doing means, let a minus x is equal to t. a minus x is equal to t means minus dx is equal to dt, तो फिर dx is equal to minus dt. When x is equal to 0, what happens? T का value will be a, and x is equal to a, what happens? T का value will be 0. Therefore, integral, I'll be considering right hand side, integral 0 to a, f of a minus x dx is equal to x k is equal to 0 means I got t is equal to a. So 0 ke sthan mein I will be substituting a. When x is equal to a, t ka value will be 0. So integral of a to 0. And here f of a minus x means f of t. And dx means I'll be writing it as minus dt. So finally what we got, here I am doing, finally what we got, that is equal to minus will be outside, integral of a to 0 f of t dt. But I'll be using the second property. So what happens, using that property means lower limit will become as upper limit, upper limit will become as lower limit. So minus minus will be getting answer 0 to a f of t dt. What is the property that I used? Integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to minus b to a f of x dx. Everything you should show. So what happens? Integral 0 to a f of t dt we got. So in this is as t and x are independent to each other. So directly I can write integral of 0 to a f of x dx. Therefore finally what conclusion can I come means, integral of 0 to a f of x dx is equal to integral of 0 to a f of a minus x dx. You can copy now. We are going to see an very very important property, minus a to a, that means integral of minus a to a f of x dx will be equal to 0 provided f of x is an odd function. And the same result, integral of minus a to a f of x dx is equal to 2 into integral 0 to a f of x dx if f of x is an even function. Before proving this, I will be once again revising what do you mean by an even function and what do you mean by an odd function. If suppose f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, whenever f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, this kind of function we call as an odd function. If suppose f of minus x is equal to f of x, we call this kind of function as even function. Once again I am repeating, whenever f of minus x is equal to minus f of x, this one we call as an odd function, and f of minus x is equal to f of x, then the function you call it as an even function. You should remember the definition for proving this particular property. So here, how can we prove? We shall be seeing. It's a lengthy proof. We should have little bit patience also. We know that WKT means, I'll call as, we know that minus a to a f of x dx is equal to, between minus a to a there will be an integer called as 0, because here a and minus a and a are real numbers. So what I'll be doing, minus a to 0 I can write this as f of x dx, and here 0 to a f of x dx. I think I splitted this into two intervals, that means minus a to 0 f of x dx plus 0 to a f of x dx. How I splitted means, if you could remember carefully, I think property 3 or 4, whenever a is less than c is less than b, that means c is a number lying between a and b, integral of a to b f of x dx can be written as a to c f of x dx plus c to b f of x dx. I think you can remember, whenever c is a number lying between a and b, and integral of a to b f of x dx means integral a to c f of x dx plus integral c to b f of x dx, right? I think you can remember that property. So what I'll be doing, I'll be calculating this particular part. How I'll be calculating means, I'll put x is equal to minus z. When I put x is equal to minus z, dx is equal to minus dz. Now when x is equal to minus a, that implies z is equal to a. When x is equal to 0, that implies z is equal to 0. Therefore, what happens in right hand side, just I will be simplifying this particular part only, beta. So integral of, whenever minus a is coming, I can put in place of z is equal to a, I can put, and 0 in place of 0 means z also will be 0, and this becomes f of minus z, and dx ke sthan mein I can write minus dz plus integral of this. As usual, I don't want to disturb this particular integral. So integral of 0 to a f of x dx. So finally, what happens? Finally, if you could observe carefully, that is equal to integral of a to 0, here minus will be there. Here minus will be there because minus dz, minus going outside, we will be getting f of minus z dz plus integral of 0 to a f of x dx. So now what I'll be doing, I want to eliminate this particular minus. How can I eliminate this particular minus means, I will make lower limit as upper limit and upper limit as lower limit, and 0 to a minus will be getting eliminated, and will be getting f of minus z dz plus integral of 0 to a f of x dx. What is the property I applied means, integral of a to b f of x dx, f of x dx is equal to minus b to a f of x dx. This is the property. I think you can see integral a to b f of x dx is equal to, this is minus beta, minus integral b to a f of x dx, the same property. And later this particular thing I can write as 0 to a f of minus x dx by the property, the very second property, or you can call as the first property because it gives rise to the same value, plus integral of 0 to a f of x dx. Now here we'll be getting two cases. But before taking the cases, what this mean, integral minus a to a f of x dx, you should remember. I will write neatly here. What is this particular thing refers for? Integral of minus a to a f of x dx, we obtained as what? Like this. Minus a to a f of x dx is equal to integral 0 to a f of minus x dx plus integral 0 to a f of x dx. So case 1, if f of x is odd, if f of x is odd means what happens? F of minus x is equal to minus f of x. So what happens? That implies integral of minus a to a f of x dx is equal to, in place of f of minus x, I can write minus f of x. So integral 0 to a minus f of x dx plus integral 0 to a f of x dx. I think minus will be getting cancelled. If minus is getting cancelled, minus coming outside means both will be getting cancelled, and this gives rise to 0. So final conclusion, what can I bring? Integral of minus a to a f of x dx is equal to 0, provided f of x is what function? Odd function. Now we shall be going for case 2. Case 2, here I am writing beta. Observe carefully everyone. I think everyone has copied so far. So case 2, if f of x, this is f beta, if f of x is an even function, if f of x is an even function means what is the meaning? I am writing that therefore f of minus x is equal to f of x. That means wherever f of minus x coming, I'll be putting f of x. Therefore, what happens finally? Integral minus a to a f of x dx is equal to integral 0 to a in place of f of minus x I will put f of x dx, and later as usual 0 to a f of x dx. So finally gives rise to 2 into integral 0 to a f of x dx. So finally what happens, integral of minus a to a f of x dx is equal to 2 into integral 0 to a f of x dx. I think you are clear with this.